Very good morning, everyone. So here we are with a new initiative, a new series on happiness. We are starting a new series today, and the title of this series is Secrets of Happiness. And we will record episode number one today with one and only our Honorable Dr. Archana Mantri. So why we have started this series? So this series is all about capturing the views of all people at Chitkara University to know how they feel about happiness, to know their own secrets on happiness. And by that, you can also adopt some of the secrets to make your life more happier and more blissful. So let us go to her and hear from her what she feels about happiness.
Thank you, Manoji. Thank you for this opportunity to speak on happiness. Ato bhilasho yadi te sukhe syat chitta prasade prathamam yatsav. If the mind is happy, the entire world is happy. And if the mind is despondent, the entire world seems to be despondent. Hence, if we, you, all of us desire happiness, we have to strive towards the happiness of the mind first. Pardon me, I have prepared a short note, and that is I am reading and telling. What is the mission of human life? If you ask me, the mission of human life is to end the miseries of material existence and attain a blissful life. All of us, if you ask me, all of us are searching for constant happiness, but we often fail in our pursuit. We may get a glimpse of happiness, but it does not last forever. May sound like a preaching by an old sage, but that is the truth. We do not want miseries, but we cannot avoid them. Scriptures, ancient literature, Vedas, all inform us that we are spiritual beings. And by nature, we are all happy beings. Anandamayo bhyasat. Then why do we suffer? If we are all imbibed happiness right from the birth, why do we suffer? And how do we rediscover the lost happiness and lead a blissful life? That's the question. In my own pursuit and understanding, I define three attributes of happiness as help somebody in need. That's the first. Respect your family and surroundings. That's the second. Love yourself. The third. But the question is, how can we do all the above three? Small cues for doing on a daily basis the three of the above. Help somebody in need, respect your family and surroundings, and love yourself. If you find somebody in real need, do not hesitate to help the entity. Be it a human, be it your surroundings, be it an animal. Because the more you give, the more it comes back to you. That's the law of nature since ancient times. The second one is be polite and forgiving to your family and to your surroundings. Forgiveness is the simplest formula of being happy. Forgive. To forget or not to forget is your own call. But forgiveness, yes. Love yourself. A loved person can only spread love and be loved by others. If the surroundings are the only reflection of yourself, and that is why when you love yourself, everyone else will love you. And if you constantly hate and curse yourself, the others are bound to do the same to you. A person who is helping, respectful, and loving can find inner happiness on a daily basis. That's the truth. Fourth and final, read good books and literature. They help you to explore within. The education system of modern times help you to explore outside. The knowledge that the outside world can give you to be filled in your mind. But exploration within gives you happiness. Finally, the epilogue, happiness is a pursuit and a quest which gives real meaning to life. It is certainly not a permanent state that you can just achieve and be there permanently. It is to be rediscovered on a daily basis with exploration within. That's what is the happiness all about. Be happy, live your life, love yourself. Thank you.
Thanks, ma'am, for this wonderful first episode. We have heard from Dr. Archana Mantri, our Honorable Vice Chancellor, what she feels about happiness. And she has given us amazing 3 secrets today. And I request all the audience to practically implement these secrets. I again tell you, again I revise that what she said. She reminded us to help others in need. Second, she reminded us to respect elders at home or at workplace. And third, she reminded a very beautiful concept to love your own self. And on top of it, she also talked about to read something every day to elevate our wisdom. So guys and everyone at Chitkara University, I request you to please implement these beautiful secrets and make your life much, much more happier. So we'll be back again with episode number 2 shortly. Until then, keep smiling. Thank you very much.